Loyola rallied from 10 points down with just over 4 minutes to play to tie the game with a little over a minute to play, but it was not enough as a turnover with 6 seconds to go on a steal by Niagara's Wanye Green led to two Green free throws to seal a 62-61 Niagara victory. Green put the Purple Eagles up 56-46 with 4:13 to play in the second half, but Loyola would score the next 4 points on a Robert Olsen three-pointer and a Dylan Cormier free throw. Antoine Mason made it an 8-point Niagara lead with 2:25 to play, but Tyler Hubbard was fouled on a three-point attempt on the right side. He hit all three free throws with 2:08 to play, and it was a 5-point Niagara advantage. Franz Rossmann went to the line after getting a steal in transition, and that was just a second after Hubbard's three free throws. Rossmann made the first of the free throws, but the second one came off the iron, no good. Hubbard tipped the rebound, Rossmann controlled it, he laid it off the glass and was fouled and went to the line with a chance to cut it to one. Rossmann hit the free throw with 2:02 to play, and that made it a 58-57 Niagara lead. A loose ball with a big scrum near midcourt popped out and Tyler Hubbard picked it up. He was fouled on the play by Niagara. Hubbard went to the free throw line and had a chance to put Loyola in front. The redshirt freshman, however, made only one of two and the game was tied at 58. The Greyhounds had an opportunity to take the lead on a Dylan Cormier steal and fast break attempt, but his layup was blocked by Amin Tanksley. On the offensive end of the court for the Purple Eagles, Green hit a runner in the lane with 56 seconds to play. He was fouled, but he missed the free throw, and that had Niagara in front 60-58. Loyola missed a three-pointer on the offensive end, and the ball went out of bounds Niagara's way, but as the Purple Eagles were trying to get it up the court, Mason had an offensive foul go against him, and that was a turnover that led to a Loyola possession. With 28 seconds on the clock, the Greyhounds ran a play, but a Cormier turnover forced by the Green steal led to Green's final two free throws that sealed the game. Anthony Winbush hit a three-pointer just before the buzzer to provide the final margin.
We had a great situation to come back and tie the game, and the crowd was electric, but we lost that game tonight over 40 minutes. It wasn't a one-minute game.
Loyola's back in action on Saturday up at the Meadowlands in New Jersey when they take on St. Peter's at 12 noon in Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference action. Loyola returns here to Reitz Arena on December 15th. That's a Saturday 7:30 p.m. start. You can watch it on MAAC in the Mid-Atlantic Sports Network or get your tickets here at www.loyolagreyhounds.com.